Hey guys, what's going on? Megan here. Three reasons to chase the pump, right? When you're training, you know, guys, I'm a big advocate of heavy lifting, heavy low reps, heavy high reps, and also pump training at the end of your workouts. You know, people call them burnouts, whatever. And a lot of people say, is it necessary to chase the pump? Of course it is. By all means, if hypertrophy is your goal, obviously, this is not a strength channel. This is a, you know, bodybuilding channel. Hypertrophy is my main goal. Everything else is second place. So three reasons to chase the pump, right? Not just because Arnold chased it, and Arnold was way ahead of his days, man. The stuff that Arnold did back in the days, science is just now finding out works, you know? So number one, you want to hit the muscle from every angle. Everybody knows that. You want to hit your fascia and your slow twitch muscle fibers, which all respond to different types of resistance, you know, high load or high time under tension. But one of the key reasons to chase the pump, either at the end of your workout or in between or whatever, I just mix it up, is number one, lactic acid, right? A lot of people underestimate the power of lactic acid. In case you don't know, lactic acid is that burn feeling you get when you doing supersets or drop sets or high rep sets, whatever. It's pretty much as a response of hypoxia, you know, when your body's low on oxygen, right? Let's say you're training too fast, oxygen doesn't have time, your blood doesn't have time to go back and shuttle oxygen back into that muscle. So you start to get that burn, right? That lactic acid burn. Now, it's no coincidence that the same time that lactic acid is released is also the same time that, you know, your growth hormone, IGF-1, all these good muscle building hormones are also released. It's a sign, you know, your body doesn't like being in that state where, you know, it's low on good oxygen. So your body will always, anybody that studies, you know, biology or human physiology, whatever, will tell you that whenever your body's in a state that it does not like, it will adapt. Right, every time, it will always adapt. In this case, your body will probably, in theory, try to make more room, right, expand the size either of the muscle or the flows around the muscle to prevent that from happening again. So, sprinters have to deal with lactic acid all the time. Marathon runners don't, and there's a big, you know, difference in the physiques apart from the way they train. But lactic acid is good; it has its benefits, right? They're still doing more research to find out exactly how it correlates with muscle growth, but there definitely is a correlation. That's one, lactic acid buildup. You want to get that. Number two is obviously, it's also in theory, is the, you know, the whole fascia stretching theory, right? The theory that the more blood you pump into the muscle, the more the fascia will stretch as the muscle expands, and, you know, the more room you have for your muscle to grow, because, you know, a very hard and tough fascia will limit, you know, how much the muscle can expand. The fascia is the tissue around the muscle, by the way, in case you don't know. So that's still a theory, but it, you know, it holds a lot of water. You know, if you take an animal that's, you know, and you look at any muscle of the animal that's covered in fascia, you'll notice it's a substance that's stretchy. But if you, for instance, I don't know, try to take a pump and try to pump water or whatever into that muscle, you'll notice it swells and the fascia stretches. With humans, it might be different, but it also might be similar. So we don't know, it's a theory, but I've noticed great gains every time I go for my pump, you know, I notice my body will stay fuller longer. So that's the second reason. The third reason to chase the pump, I would say, in my opinion, is obviously sarcoplasmic hypertrophy, right? Everybody knows what the two types of hypertrophy. Sarcoplasmic hypertrophy is mainly, it's not necessarily the muscle growing, it's mainly the area around the muscle expanding to be able to store more glycogen, more fluids, whatever. So it's like the fluids around the muscle growing and expanding, which gives you that full look, you know, that fuller look, which is it's still hypertrophy in a way, you know. So those are three reasons to chase the pump. You know, I'm a big fan of Serge Nubre style training. Serge Nubre, look him up. He's a great bodybuilder. He was natural, he claimed natural, and he had an amazing physique. And in fact, he was one of the guys that was up there with Arnold. Amazing physique. And if you look at his workouts, this guy did crazy volume, and he always chased the pump. Always chased the pump, right? He was also strong. He had like over 400-pound bench press, but he would do his chest workouts for like 135 pounds, you know? And, you know, he had a phenomenal chest. He'll do super high volume. I don't recommend anybody to do the exact volume he did, but that's what worked for him. He was a big believer in pump training. Phil Heath, feeling the muscle. Kai Greene, Jay Cutler, you know, all these enhanced athletes also, you know, are big advocates of high volume training for hypertrophy. Also strength. Do not neglect strength. I'm not saying, you know, do only one. In bodybuilding, there's never any absolutes. You want to do both for your fast twitch, your slow twitch, and your strength or whatever. But do not neglect pump training, right? There's so many people. You know, I remember watching Pump and Iron back in the days, and I would hear Arnold talk about the pump, and I thought, man, that's just for show, whatever. No, it's not just for show. You know, the pump has a part to play in building muscle. All right, guys, hope that helps. Three reasons. I'm out of here.